Welcome back to the Finish Line Project. I have a special topic for you. I am going to discuss four different types of soft tissue changes which may occur in response to maladaptive dentures or overwearing of dentures. The first condition that we are going to discuss, talk about, is papillary hyperplasia. Papillary hyperplasia is basically a result of a relief chamber that may be made in a denture in case a sort of relief chamber is to be made to the denture to enhance the suction of the denture. Papillary hyperplasia is found to occur. It generally occurs after the denture has been worn, placed for a few days, or it may occur over a long period of time. Ill maintenance of the denture may also contribute to papillary hyperplasia. Now, what are the features of papillary hyperplasia? Papillary hyperplasia may occur as a single lesion, and this lesion will appear soft, tender, and red in color. It will be slightly movable on palpation, and in case a histological section is cut out, there will be a presence of inflammatory cell infiltrate from the surrounding connective tissue. What is the treatment? The treatment is very simple. There are two types of treatment. One is conservative and the other is surgical. Conservative treatment will involve the elimination of a relief chamber of the denture and the adjustment of the denture wherever required. And the surgical treatment will involve surgical excision, will basically involve the removal of the hyperplasia and its replacement with a supraperiosteal flap. The surgical excision may also be done in case of pinpoint multiple lesions on the palate. So surgical excision can be done for each of the single lesions and cautery can be also be done for the same. The next lesion I am going to talk about is epilus fissuratum. Epilus fissuratum is a result of an ill-fitting denture. If the denture does not fit well and keeps hurting the patient in the sulcular region, what happens is that the tissue in the sulcus will begin to proliferate, and this may proliferate either as single fold or as multiple fold, and this proliferation will eventually prevent the seating of the denture. After a period of time, if the patient feels that it is constantly impinging the denture, on the sulcus, the patient will report to you. The first thing that has to be done in this case is that the presence of any kind of cancer has to be ruled out. That can be done through biopsy of the tissue. There are two methods. If the biopsy of cancer is ruled out, then we can proceed either with a conservative method of treatment or a surgical method of treatment. In case the method of treatment is conservative, basically it's about telling the patient to stop wearing the denture for a period of time and advising them to use something like mucopane or Orasor gel, constantly massaging the region. This will help the lesion to subside and the lesion will gradually regress. In case the lesion is widespread and large, then comes the option of surgical excision which can be performed. Next, I'm going to talk about denture stomatitis. Denture stomatitis is basically caused by wearing the denture at night. Some patients have the habit of not taking off the denture at night, and this leads to denture stomatitis. What happens in denture stomatitis is that if your entire tissue may be localized or generalized inflammation, this will cause continuous irritation to the patient. There will be itching and there will be a sort of redness that is present all around the palate and localized to one area. What is the treatment for this? The treatment for this is again either conservative or surgical. Surgical only in case of the proliferative lesion is present. In case no proliferative lesion is present, the treatment is simply conservative. The patient has to get the denture adjusted and the patient has to stop wearing the denture for a while. Apply an ointment such as Orasor or Dologel at the same time. Keep massaging the tissues. Alright, a multivitamin may be required and it may be given to the patient. After all these procedures are done, you may place a temporary, for the time being, you may place a soft liner. Once the patient has adjusted well to the soft liner, it may be again replaced by hard acrylic. The next lesion that I am going to talk about is denture sore mouth. Denture sore mouth is generally caused by the overuse of a denture, and you will notice that the mucosa is throughout reddish. Overuse of the denture may mean that the patient has used it beyond the recommended time of 5 years, probably used it for 12 years or 15 years, and is still continuing to use the denture. What happens eventually, the food particles start getting embedded inside the acrylic, and at the same time the denture becomes unhygienic to wear over time. The treatment for this is simply conservative. You have to change the denture. Thank you.